the Muni is trying to do that. Very sincerely reaching out the living entity. Very genuinely reaching the living entity. Like when everyday Lord Chaitanya used to send Advaita Acharya and Nityananda Prabhu for preaching. So when Nityananda Prabhu and Advaita Acharya, they go on preaching, they knock at each door. And when the householder comes and opens the door, he won't see anyone. Then he will see this eminent, glowing, brilliant personalities lying flat on the ground and holding the householder's feet and begging and saying, please accept this message of Krishna. Very genuinely preaching. You know, even Ramanujacharya's, you know what he say, guru, not exactly guru, Ramanujacharya's, guru, Yamunacharya. Ramanujacharya had many multiple gurus and one guru is Yamunacharya. And Yamunacharya, the story of Yamunacharya is very interesting. He was a disciple of a great spiritual master and a grandson of a great spiritual master. So till the age of 5-10, he was practicing all aspects of spirituality. This boy, small boy. Then by the will of providence, by the arrangement of nature, he became the king. Once this boy became a king, he was completely into kingdom, managing, expanding his kingdom, behind name, fame, glory. And he was fully into it and he forgot the finer aspects of spirituality. He forgot spirituality totally. Then when the spiritual master was passing away, he told one of his sannyas disciple, if you really want to please me, somehow get this boy back to spirituality. This one seva you do, you will please me to the core. And he told one of the best sannyasi, just to preach one person and bring him back. That is all his seva is. So the sannyasi went there to the kingdom. How much ever he tried, he could not reach the king. It's a very powerful person. The boy has become a very powerful king. And nobody could reach him. And every day he was busy in expanding his kingdom and power and fame. So the sannyasi found a method. He will collect a very special type of saag, karela. Something, spinach, or karela. Very special, very, very good one. Then he will take it to the cook of the king and he will say, this is very good and king will like it and by cooking this, it will give a lot of good thing, you know. He explained the glories of that karela. And the cook also, because a sadhu is bringing, and cook also very obediently started feeding the king every day, cooking that and serving the king. And king really liked it. And this was going on for months and months together. And purposely, in between, the sadhu, the sannyasi, stopped giving this. So one day the karela is missing, second day the karela is missing. Then the king asked, what happened? Nowadays you are not serving me the karela? Then the cook said, I don't know. One sannyasi used to bring and give every day, but I don't see him for last 2 days. What? A sannyasi brought you, brought these things. So if he comes tomorrow, ask him to meet me. Then in this way, that sannyasi got an audience with the king. He took so much pain just to bring one person back. Anyway, it's a big story. Finally, that person became the guru. The boy came back into spirituality and became the guru of Ramanujacharya. So preaching means genuine transfer of mercy and compassion, nothing else. Just being very honest in that transformation. And that's what Narada is doing here. And this particular verse is speaking about animal killing, because in those days, in previous yugas, they were used to do animal sacrifices. They used to kill animals and offer in the yajna, fire sacrifice. They used to do animal sacrifice. But in Kali Yuga, animal sacrifice is banned. 5 things are banned in Kali Yuga. Ashwamedham, Gavalambam, Sanyasam, Palapautrikam, Devarena, Sutotpatim, Kalau Pancha, Vivarjayet. Ashwamedha, horse sacrifice. Gavalamba, cow sacrifice. Sanyasa, sanyasa ashram. Palapautrikam, Pitru Puja, worshipping forefathers. Devarena Sutotpatim. If the couple don't have children, they can take the help of husband's brother, wife's sister. All these things were allowed in the previous yugas. These 5 things are banned in Kali Yuga because you cannot do this process honestly in Kali Yuga. So animal sacrifice, killing animals, you know, we all know this, even this present situation is just because of killing innocent animals and reptiles. Such a sinful thing. Mother Nature will definitely react. So when we talk, discuss these topics, devotees may think, anyway, I am a vegetarian for last 4 years, 8 years, 10 years, 20 years, 15 years, whatever it is. So this is not applicable to me. It is not applicable to me, so it's okay. But actually, animal killing is also applicable to us. How? See, we all know when we kill animal, the quality called mercy disappears from us. So when you kill an animal, we are merciless. When we are merciless, then one pillar of dharma is disappearing from my life. And when the pillar disappears, and chanting Krishna, Chirka Krishna's name will become very difficult. So when we kill, we lose mercy. In the same way, you know from Bhagavad Gita, every living entity has got 2 bodies, a gross body and a subtle body. We have 2 bodies, okay? So when somebody kills an animal, he is killing the gross body, okay? But we devotees, because we are into Krishna consciousness, we have stopped killing gross bodies. We are not doing that sin anymore. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, we continue killing subtle body. Yes or no? We hurt people mentally. By our words, by our action, by our thoughts, by our comments, we still hurt people mentally. Mind, intelligence and ego becomes a subtle body. And even now we prick the subtle body with the knife, with our tongue. We prick them, we hurt them. That means we are killing subtle bodies. A normal man who doesn't know this philosophy, he is killing the gross body of animals. We are killing the subtle body of human being. Devotees, sadhus, pure people. So we are also doing the same sin, but in a different level. They are killing gross body, we are killing the subtle body. So this law, these 4 principles, no meat eating, no gambling, no intox, whatever, is still applicable. So by hurting the subtle body, we are slowly losing this quality called mercy. So normal people have to follow that in a different level. We have to follow this in a different level by not killing the subtle body of people. And Buddha said this famous line of Buddha, no living by killing. We cannot live by killing someone. No living by killing. So normal man kills the gross body. We kill the subtle body. So if we really want to progress in Krishna consciousness, we should stop killing the subtle body.